Hello, welcome to Young Sewing Solutions. Today we're going to be making abaya in this style. It's a double layered style which has like an overcoat of a jacket on top and an under piece that's been attached and sewn together. Now basically the way this is sewn together is it's sewn all the way, the sleeves are sewn together, it's sewn together up to the shoulders all as one, and to cut this what we're going to do is initially what we've done is folded the fabric over and left an overhanging lapped piece. So this is the center fold of the fabric, and the piece that comes I will be cutting into this for the top side. The way you need to take the measurement for this is the shoulder measurement you need to take all the way across to the opening of the arm. So basically this is what So with your arms open, you need to measure from how long the length of the sleeve. This is the center fold. So you sort of need to measure from, point this out to you. Basically what you need to be doing is measuring from the center of your neck piece here all the way across to the full length of the sleeve, preferably covering your wrist point. So that's the main measurement that we're going to be using for the putting out of this abaya. Now I've chosen this is a chiffon fabric with the embossed silver foil on, and it's actually going to hopefully get you actually need to get a second person to do this measurement for you, because it's quite hard to do it yourself, although I haven't got anybody here. So I need half of that measurement is 28 inches. So measuring 28 inches from the center here, I'm going to measure across, which comes to this point. And then you need to measure the full length from the shoulder all the way down to the ankle point. And we're going to make this 54 inches in length. Which is to here. The next measurement we're going to be using is our length of our sleeve, which is from the top of the shoulder point to the pit of the armhole, and this is just to determine how much of a sleeve cut we're going to be doing. I'm going to be using a 9-inch cut, and that 9 inches is going to be formed from the shoulder point. So I know my shoulder is 14 inches, approximately 15 inches. So at 15 inches, I'm going to go 9 inches down, and this is where the curve of the armhole is going to come. So decide on the width of your sleeve and then curve down to the armhole point. The other measurement we need over here is our bust measurement to determine the width.
She's in the way,
okay, they're in that box downstairs.
Alright, she's not coming today, mom. She's not feeling well. She's been dying all day.
Oh.
Huh?
Oh.
She's just gonna go to sleep.
So What we're going to have is the gear of this jubba. We're going to be making, it's a front open jubba, and this we're going to be making 18 inches on the one side, so in total it'll be half the width of 36 inches, which is about that much, about a yard. Now you don't want to overly go under it, because what happens is if it's overly wide, you tend to it tends to drag a bit. So I'm going to curve it out on the waist area and then give it a bit of a shape. So if I give you some dimensions at this point, what we have is 18 inches at the bottom. At the waist area, you take your measurement for the waist, measure the length from the top down to the waist point and curve it in. Your chest area will be slightly wider. From the top of the sleeve to from the top of the shoulder to the sleeve is the measurement for your armhole length, and then the length of the full half a sleeve and the width of your sleeve that you require. That is basically it. So we're going to put into this, and then the next part to this we're going to be putting. At the point of the center of the back neckline, I'm going to just notch it, and then the neckline itself is in like a V shape,